Sathyabhama Institute of Science and Technology, deemed to be University, Chennai.
For admission, contact 9940-58263 and 9940-16807. For further queries, visit www.sathyabhama.ac.in.
Hi, good morning all.
Good morning.
Warm greetings from Sathyabhama Institute of Science and Technology, deemed to be University, Chennai. My name is R.M. Joni. I'm going to host today's webinar. Hope everyone is safe and well at home. We are elated about your overwhelming responses. Thank you all for your great support. On behalf of the organizing committee, I take the privilege in welcoming you all to the live webinar on factors influencing the design of a perfect mini solar power plant for your dream house, organized by Sathyabhama IEI student branch in association with the Institution of Engineers India. I also welcome Mr. K. Kasirajan, who has joined us today from Malaysia to handle this session. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you.
It is indeed a unique pleasure and privilege for us to express our sincere gratitude to our founder chancellor, Colonel Dr. Jebia, who always showers his divine blessings. We take this opportunity to express our deepest gratitude and earnest thanks to our Chancellor, Ma'am, Dr. Marizina Johnson, and our President, Sir, Dr. Mari Johnson, for the continuous support and high endeavors in motivating us to organize this online webinars during this COVID-19 crisis situation. Coming to today's topic, solar energy. Solar energy is a power from the sun, is a vast, is inexhaustible, and a clean resource, is it? Sunlight or solar energy can be used directly for heating and lighting our homes and for business purposes and for generating electricity and for heating and as well as for solar cooling and a variety of other commercial and industrial applications. The key aspects of passive solar design are the thermal mass, insulation, the angle and direction of the sun orientation, the placement of the operable windows, overhangs, and shading, and ventilation and circulation, the surface colors, and the geographical location. In today's session, let us know all these things in detail. And today we have Mr. Kasi K. Kasirajan, sir, senior lecturer, Faculty of Engineering and IT, Masa University, Selangor, Malaysia. We welcome you, sir, once again. Coming to his profile, Mr. K. Kasirajan has completed his undergraduate degree in Electrical and Electronics Engineering from the Government College of Engineering and the Master of Engineering in the Specialization for Electronics and Drives in the year 2005. He has total 20 years of experience in teaching, and now currently he is working in Masa University, Malaysia since 2015. He is also a member of professional societies like ISTE and IET. He has attended many number of trainings, seminars, international workshops, and the faculty development programs in his specialized area. He has given many number of invited lectures in engineering colleges in the field of special electrical machines. He has organized national conferences, seminars, workshops, and symposiums. We are very happy to have you here, sir, to deliver a talk on factors influencing the design of a perfect mini solar power plant for your dream house. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yes, sir, you can start.
Okay, thank you very much, ma'am. First of all, I would like to thank the organizer, Dr. Karthikeyan, sir, Ms. Joni, ma'am, Dr. Vardharajan, sir, and my friend, Dr. Anthony Samrat, my Dean, Professor Liam, and Deputy Dean, Dr. Ayman, my friends, colleagues, and students, and participants for being here. And also thank Sathyabhama Institute of Technology for giving me this opportunity. So this is a very good topic, factors influencing the design of your perfect mini solar power plant for your dream house. So everyone having idea of building a very good dream house. So what are the factors we may consider for our dream house? How to build our house which is in our dream? So each and everyone having their own ideas to build their beautiful dream house. So to modify as well as to give extra care about your house, we need some solar power plant. So mini solar power plant you can build in your house to beautify your house further. How to design a solar power plant? Lot of members can dream a solar power plant, how to install a good solar power plant in your mind. But how to start? We don't know. Where to start? We don't. So for those people, this is very good platform. And after attending this webinar, you can easily build your solar power plant by considering some important factors. What are the factors influencing the design of a perfect solar power plant? Okay, so now let us see one by one. Next slide, please.
Sir, you itself can change, sir.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Yes.
So, physics of PV cell, that is photovoltaic cell. As we know, the solar power is abundant and enormous. Each and everyone having the solar energy we can have, isn't it? So, with the help of this solar, we can convert the solar light energy to electrical energy. So the what is required for converting the solar light to electrical energy, that is photovoltaic cells. So with the help of photovoltaic cells, we can easily convert the light energy to electrical energy. The photons, due to the photon, the electrons can move in the solar cells. Thereby, the electrical current is flowing in the load circuits. So, this is the actual fundamental of PV cell. Not only electrical energy, we can also get thermal energy also, heat energy, for heating the water. So, that is different area. And we can use the solar energy for satellites. In the satellites also, we are using the PV cells for operating the satellites. So these are some applications, like road, we can power a solar road. This is current trend, solar road. So in future also, we are easily power the solar roads. How to power the solar roads? That is research topic nowadays. Here, with the help of LED lights, we can give the signals left, right, like that. We can give the signals with the help of LED lights in solar roads. And solar light, here lot of color in the solar light. So by discriminating the light, solar color, that is also research topic. And here, step by step, we can see as solar energy is definitely abundant and solar is absolutely free and available to everyone, so we can plan for solar. Now, differentiation of solar cell to solar array. What is a basic solar cell? Actually, solar cell is a tiny element. It produces less voltage, nearly half voltage it can produce. And number of solar cells connected in series to form a module, solar module. So it produces more electrical energy compared to cell. And number of solar modules can connected in series to form a string, that is said to be solar string. And the number of strings are connected in parallel to form the solar array. Actually, the solar array is available in case of our solar power plants. So factors that impact energy output. What are the factors? Climate and weather location, temperature. High temperatures can reduce solar panel energy efficiency. Then panel orientation. So the panel orientation is very important factor to increase the efficiency of your solar panel. It should face the south facing, then it can increase the efficiency. Then shading also affects your performance of your solar power plant. If due to some small branches of your tree or birds can shade, due to shading, these panel modules connected in series get affected. Then natural efficiency drop, that is another factor. So these are the factors we need to consider for designing our solar power plant. Based on this, we need to improve the performance of your solar efficiency. And solar panel efficiency drop about 0.5 to 1% every year. Sun hours. What is sun hours means? Time spent by the sun in a position that generates high peak energy. So that is said to be sun hours. Actually, in 2020, some solar cells are said to be top 10 based on their efficiency. So in the 10th position, dye sensitized solar cells is available. Its efficiency 11.9 to 12.3%. Then organic solar cells, its efficiency 15.6 to 17.4%. Cadmium telluride cells, its efficiency 22.1%. Polycrystalline, so its efficiency 22.3% to 22.8%. Thin film CLGS cells, its efficiency 22.9 to 23.4%. Then unstabilized perovskite cells, its efficiency 23.7 to 25.2%. Then monocrystalline cells. Nowadays, more applications are using the monocrystalline cells only. Its efficiency 26.1%. Gallium arsenate cells, its efficiency 30%. Tantalum petroxide cells, efficiency 28%. And this is the first position, multi-junction solar cells. So in future, lot of applications will replace the existing ones to multi-junction solar cells only. More research also going on to develop further the multi-junction solar cells. Its efficiency is the top one, 39.2%. So those who are going to do the research works, you can concentrate on multi-junction solar cells. In future, it will be replacing all the solar cells. Then, this is the main area, our topic, PV system design criteria. Actually, this is purely design, fully electrical. And first, there are 5 steps you have to consider for designing a perfect solar power plant for your house. With one example, I can tell you. So first step is determine power consumption demands. So what are the power electrical appliances you are going to use in your house. So based on that electrical appliances, you can calculate the total watts in each appliance. So total watts you can calculate for all the components you are going to design the solar power plant based on the electrical appliances. So that is the first step. Then based on the wattage hours, we can design the solar panels. So that is the second step, size of the PV modules. So what size is required for your demand? So that is the second step, size of the PV modules. And third step, inverter sizing. Inverter is a device, power electronic device actually. It converts the DC to AC. Since the solar power plant produces only DC, so that DC can be converted to AC with the help of inverter. Since our all electrical appliances are using AC only, isn't it? So we need to convert the DC to AC. With the help of inverters, we can convert DC to AC. Then battery sizing. Actually, we need battery for during night. Night time there is no solar, so we need battery. With the help of battery, we can store the energy in the daytime. During the night time, we can utilize the battery power. So for that, we can design battery. Then solar charge controller sizing. Solar charge controller sizing. Actually, here two types of solar charge controllers. One is PWM and MPPT. Mostly we are using the PWM and MPPT. So each one having its own advantages and disadvantages. What is the need of solar charge controller? Actually, battery should not overcharged. So for cut off the power to charge battery, it is done by your solar charge controller. And moreover, if the battery reduced to certain level, then we need to charge the battery. So those things are taken care of by your solar charge controller. And during the shutdown period also, the solar panel should not charge. So during that time also, the solar charge controller cut off from power from solar array. So for these purposes, main purposes, solar charge controller is designed. So that is also required for. So these, if you are well versed in these five steps, then you can easily design your solar mini power plant for your beautiful house. So these are the five important steps. First one, determine the power consumption demands. It is required to find the total power and energy consumption of all loads that is supplied by PV system. So that is the first step. For that, you need to calculate the total watt hours per day for each appliance. Total watt hours per day for each appliance used. Then add the watt hours needed for all appliances together to get the whatever per day which must be delivered to your appliances. Then calculate the total whatever per day needed for the PV modules. How to calculate the total whatever? Total whatever per day must be provided by the panels equal to total appliances whatever per day. So for one day, how much whatever multiplied by 1.3. This is a factor. Why we are using the 1.3? Actually, for example, if your total watt hours 100, then we must design for 130%. 130% for considering the losses. and then other factors affecting the performance. So we need to design for 130%. So for that purpose, I put the 1.3 and multiplied by energy loss, other energy losses. So using these things, we can calculate the watt hours per day. So 130% is very important. Then size the PV modules. Different size of PV modules will produce different amount of power based on its efficiency. For example, the monocrystalline efficiency is higher compared to polycrystalline. So polycrystalline efficiency is less compared to efficiency of same size. So to find out the sizing of PV module, the total peak watts produced needed. The peak watt produced depends on two factors: size of the module and climate of your site location, whether sunny throughout the year or some duration it is cool climate, based on the climate of your house location. So we have to consider these two, size and climate. Then we have to consider panel generation factor, which is different in each situated locations. For I have considered for Thailand. For Thailand, the panel generation factor is 3.43. So this one, how to calculate the panel generation factor, I will tell after some time. So that is very important for calculating the total watt peak rating for PV panels. That is equal to total watt hours per day needed for PV modules divided by 3.43, that constant panel generation factor. Then from that, we can decide the number of panels required for our solar house. So how to calculate the number of panels, total watt hours per needed for PV modules already calculated, divided by 3.43 times rated output watt peak, the PV module. That is, the PV modules comes in certain rating only in the market. So based on the rating, we have to select. For example, 110 peak, then that we can consider, or 220 or 330, like that. Based on the availability, we can select and we can calculate the number of PV panels. So the result is the minimum number of PV panels. If more PV panels are installed, means better performance, not very high, nearer to your answer. Then that will improve your battery. If minimum number of PV panels is selected, means your battery performance will be get affected. Comparison of PV modules. Actually, it is best to make comparisons based on current information provided by manufacturers combined with the specific requirements of your application. Two figures that are useful in comparing the modules are, first one, modules price per watt. Naturally, price is very important, isn't it? Module price per watt and rated power output per area, that is efficiency, based on efficiency per area, how much efficiency or how much rated power output. Then calculate cost per watt by cost per watt equal to module's price divided by its rated output in watts. Then calculate the watts per area. Watts per area is calculated by rated output over its area. Inverter sizing. Converts DC output of solar panels into a clean AC current for home appliances or to grid lines. The input rating should never be less than the total watt of appliances. The inverter must have some nominal voltage as your battery. For standalone systems, the inverter must be large enough to handle the total amounts of watts you will using at one time. The inverter size should be 25 to 30% bigger than total watts of appliances. So 25 to 30% bigger than your total watt of appliances. So that is another important factor we need to consider. 25 to 30% bigger than total watts. In case of appliance type of motor or compressor, then inverter size should be minimum 3 times the capacity of those appliances. Minimum 3 times. Since motor and compressor starting current is high, very high, isn't it? That is to handle the surge current during starting current or surge current. So for that purpose, the inverter size should be 3 times bigger compared to your total watt hours. So this is another important factor. If your motor or compressor, then 3 times the capacity, total capacity. For grid tie systems or grid connected system, the input rating of the inverter should be same as PV rating to allow for safe and efficient operation. Actually, 3 types of connections we can use. One is grid on system, then hybrid. Actually, we are seeing about the grid off system. Only battery based. Grid on system is different category. Hybrid is more advantageous compared to these two. Grid on better than grid off. But if you can design the grid off, then easily go for grid on and total. That is hybrid. So fundamental, we grid off is, then we can extend our solar panel. Battery sizing. Its battery stores energy for supplying to electrical appliances. Battery type recommended for solar PV is deep cycle battery, mostly recommended. Deep cycle battery is specifically designed for to be discharged to low energy level and rapid recharge or cycle recharge and discharge day after day for years. So for that purpose, can go for deep cycle battery. The battery should be large enough to store sufficient energy to operate the appliances at night and cloudy days. Moreover, another factor is days of autonomy. How many days we need the battery charging? That is said to be days of autonomy. I have taken for 3 days. Based on 3 days, I designed the battery size. So days of autonomy, number of days that you need the system to operate when there is no power produced by PV panels. So battery capacity usually in ampere hours. Battery capacity in ampere hours. Total watt hours per day used by appliances multiplied by days of autonomy divided by 0.85 multiplied by 0.6 times nominal battery rating. That is voltage. Usually 12 volts, 24 volt, 48 volt batteries are available. 24 and 48 volt batteries. So which one is suitable for us? We can select either 12 volt or 24 volt based on our requirement. We can select the battery voltage, nominal battery voltage. The 0.6 is for 60% efficiency. So 60% we have taken, and 0.85 for power factor. So these are the constant values which is taken to calculate the battery capacity. Then a battery depth of discharge. So depth of discharge varies from battery to battery. The percentage of battery that has been discharged relative to the overall capacity of the battery. For example, if you are going for charging your mobile phone. So in the mobile phone, how much discharged? We will say 50% charge, 75% charge. So percentage, isn't it? 75%, 100%, like that. So here, we cannot wait up to 100%. So that is the depth of discharge. How much depends upon batteries, it varies. 96%, 90%, 84%, like that. For example, if you have a Tesla Powerwall that holds 13.5 kilowatt hours of capacity and you discharge 13 kilowatt hour, the depth of discharge is approximately 96%, not up to 13.5, 13 kilowatt hour. So that is from depth of discharge. So see, different battery having different depth of discharge. Tesla Powerwall 96%. So total size is 14 kilowatt hour. DOD is 13.5. That is recharging kilowatt hour is 13.5. Depth of discharge 96% for Tesla Powerwall. Similarly for other batteries. Then final step is solar charge controller size. See, used to regulate the voltage and current. So that is the main purpose. Used to regulate the voltage and current from solar plant and voltage to the battery. So how much voltage should be given to battery? So that all decided by your solar power controller. So in the solar power controller, we already designed all the programmings. And also it prevents battery from overcharging. So battery should not overcharge. And then only its life can be extended. Life, good life for your battery. Set the solar charge controller to match the voltage of PV array and batteries. So we need to select the solar charge controller so that it matches with your PV array and battery voltages. Then identify which type of solar charge controller is right for your application, whether pulse width modulator in your PWM solar charge controller or MPPT. MPPT means maximum power point tracking. So by tracking the voltage and current for current present situation, present time, what is the voltage and current? So it is compared with the maximum power. So that is called maximum power point tracking. Based on that, it tracks the voltage and current. So that is separate topic, research topic. Then sizing of the controller depends on total PV current which is delivered to the controller, and depends on PV panel configuration, either it is connected in series or parallel. So for series, the voltages can be added and current is same. But in case of parallel, voltage is constant, current is increases. So this is the connection of panels in parallel, and this one is connection of this also parallel, and this is connected in series. Then according to standard practice, sizing of solar controller is to take the short circuit current. So we need to take the short circuit current for sizing. So for every solar panel, backside of the solar panel, they all details are available. The short circuit current, open circuit voltage, the watt rating of solar panel, everything is available backside of your solar panel. Short circuit means connecting the two terminals with help of some wire, short circuit. So during that short circuit, how much current is flowing? That is the short circuit current. And open circuit, if there is no load is connected to your solar panel, and get the voltage reading. That is your open circuit voltage. So for short circuit current, you have to multiply it by 1.3. That is, as I said earlier, 130%. So 1.3. Solar charge controller rating equal to short circuit current times 1.3. So that is the solar charge controller rating. current rating for solar charge controller. So that is taken from your short circuit current. So this is actually one solar panel ratings. So here maximum short circuit current is 9.01 amps ISC, and open circuit voltage VOC is 46.2 volt. So that is the maximum possible values for this. And maximum power P max is 315 watts. For MPPT charge controller, sizing will be different from PWM, and where the MPPT actually is suitable for large size system. For large size system, MPPT is better, and for cold condition, cloudy seasons, far from equator, winter time, and during this time, 25 to 30% more power can be extracted from MPPT controller compared with your PWM. But for small area, small power plants, we can go for PWM. So this is one example how I solve for a small house. Okay, now in your house you are going to design one 18 watt fluorescent lamp with electronic ballast used for 4 hours per day. So I have taken 4 hours per day fluorescent lamp 18 watts, fan 16 watts rating 2 hours per day, and refrigerator 75 watts 24 hours per day, but the compressor switched on for 12 hours and off for 12 hours. So only 12 hours you need to calculate for the calculation. So 12 hours 75 watts for 12 hours refrigeration. The system will be powered by 12 volt DC. So the panel voltage they have given us 12 volt and 110 watt peak. Peak watt is 110. So you need to design for this house 110 watt peak PV module, and voltage rating is 12 volt. So this is the rating of PV module, 12 volt and 110 watt peak. So how many number of panels needed with this rating for this setup? Fluorescent lamp, one fluorescent lamp, one fan, and one refrigeration. So we are going to design for this simple example. So first step is you need to calculate total watts. So fluorescent lamp 18 watts, fan 60, refrigerator 75 watts. So if you add all the total power watts, then you will get 153 watts. Then energy watt hours for fluorescent lamp 72, that is 18 times 4 number of hours 72. In for fan power total watts 60 hours, number of hours 2, so 60 times 2 is 120. Refrigerator 75 watts and 12 hours, so 75 times 12 is 900. So if you add all the energy watt hours, you will get 1092 total watt hours. Total load is 153 watts. Total energy required by watt hours 1092 watt hours. So for this we are going to calculate number of panels. So first step, total watt hours per day must be provided by panels equal to total appliances watt per day multiplied by 1.3. So total appliances 18 is the rating of fluorescent lamp, 4 hours 60 fan, and 2 hours 75 for your refrigeration, and multiplied by 24 hours divided by 2. Since 12 hours it is on, 12 hours off, so on time is calculated. So 75 times 12, so watt hours per day is 1092 watt hours. Now we have to multiply it by 130%, that is 1.3 factor. Then total watt hours per PV is 1419.6 watt hours. So for safety purpose, we are considering the 130%. Second step, number of panels. So how many number of panels required for 110 watts? Total watt hours per day needed divided by 3.43 times rated output of PV. So output of PV is given 110. This 3.43 is power generation factor. Total watt hours per day is 1419.6. So you substitute, then you will get 3.7625. So it is nearer to 4. So 4 is better. Don't go for 3. Don't go for 3. If you go for 3 means your battery performance will be decreased. So lifetime of your battery will be get affected. So go for more than required. So 3.7 means required, more than required is 4. So we can go for 4 number of panels rating 110 watts panel needed. So power generation hours normally 5 to 8 hours. Here for calculation purpose I have taken 7.6 hours times 4.44. That is 0.45 I have taken, that 3.43. 0.45 how we can get. So we can get the sunlight from morning, example for example, 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. So if you consider this one, how the power panel is generating the power. For example, at 8 a.m. 0 power generation, 9 a.m. 25 50 75 100. So at 12 p.m. it is taken as 100% power generation. Then after that it reduces 75 50 25 0. So this is required to calculate the power generation factor. So if you add all the factors and divide by 9, so 9 period, so divided by 9, then you will get 0.44. So 0.44 times 7.6, then 3.43 you will get. Then third step, inverter sizing. So inverter size should be 25 to 30% bigger than total watt hours appliances. So here 18 plus 16 plus 75 is 153 watts. So you have to multiply it by 30%. So you will get inverter sizes 198, and rated load is 153. Inverter power factor is 0.8. So you get 1.25. So inverter size can be between 191.25 to 198.9 watts. So this is your inverter size. So what is available in the market in this range, you can select nearer to this one. More than this one is better. Then fourth step, battery sizing. So battery capacity, total watt hours per day used by appliances multiplied by days of autonomy, whole divided by 0.85 times 0.6 times nominal battery voltage. So if you substitute the total watt hours, then nominal battery is 12 volt. Since your solar panel is voltage is given 12 volt, 110 watts, isn't it? So same voltage should be for nominal battery voltage. So 12 total ampere watt required, 535.29 ampere hours. So this is the total ampere hours for 3 days of autonomy. Days of autonomy I have taken 3. You can take 1 or 2 based on your requirement. So for calculation purpose I have taken days of autonomy as 3. So for 3 days of autonomy, total ampere hours required is 535 ampere hours. So battery should be rated 12 volt. So more than 535, 600 ampere hours is available at the market. So I have taken 12 volt, 600 ampere hours for 3 days of autonomy. So this is the battery sizing. Then fifth step is solar charge controller sizing. So maximum power is 110 watt peak, maximum voltage 16.7 volt DC, maximum current 6.6 amps, Open circuit voltage 20.7 amps, short circuit current 7.5 amps. So with this, we can design. So solar charge control rating equal to 4 strings times 7.5 amps times 1.3. That is equal to 39 amps. So solar charge controller rating is 39 amps. Why it is 4 strings? Since we are using 4 panels, isn't it? Previous slide. So here we are taking number of panels required is 4 panels. 4 panels are said to be 4 strings. So 4 strings times 7.5 ampere. So 7.5 ampere is the short circuit current. Short circuit current is ISC is 7.5 amps. So times 1.3, that is 130. For safety purposes, we can go for 130%. Not exactly 100%. We should go for 130% for safety reasons. So solar charge controller 39 amps required. So rated 40 amps. So 40 amps is available in the market. So 40 amps, 12 volt or greater, 12 volt or 24 volt like that. And so charge controllers still require lower voltages of 12 volt, 24 volt or 48 volt to match the voltage of the battery string. So string inverters we are actually using, but in case of string inverters, lot of demerits are available. For example, one demerit is due to tree, leaf of your tree or bats, due to bats, one part of your string is shaded. If one is shaded, means connected in series, all these modules in the same string get affected. So its efficiency will be reduced by 50% due to shading of one module. Okay, so that is the disadvantage of string inverters. Actually, string inverters are used, but due to the disadvantage of the string inverters, we are going for improvements. What are the improvements? Let us see. So before that, result of your beautiful house. So with this, total watt hours by PV. So the PV model should give 1420 watt hours. Number of panels, 4 panels for your beautiful house with rating of 110 peak watts. Inverter size 198. Maximum values I have taken, that is 191 to 198, isn't it? So I have taken the maximum value, 198 watts. Battery 12 volt, 600 amps. So maximum 3 days of autonomy. And solar charge controller 40 amps. So this is your design of your beautiful house. Okay. Initially, the two couples. So initially, couples they are going to design your house. Initially, this requirement is 675 kilowatt hour. After a certain time, due to children, we need 737 kilowatt hour. After buying the electrical appliances, we need 998. Further, if you extend 1657, and further if you go for car, electrical car, then 1926 watt. So like this we can extend the solar panels. So based on this you have to plan for your solar house. Initially the requirement is less, but after 5 years, after 10 years, you have to plan widely. So after 5 years, definitely I can say we are going for solar cars. So we need to charge your electrical vehicles. So for that, you need to plan now itself. So next, research. So what are the research we can do? Some of you can think about research in solar. In future, definitely solar will dominate our world, since due to the diminishing nature of our fossil fuels, petrol, the diesel, everything going to diminish. Coal definitely going to diminish in future. So we have to go for alternate energy source, renewable energy source. So better option is solar. So what are the research topics related with your solar? Step by step I can tell you. Actually, these are some drawbacks, isn't it? So if you any shading, see one bird is shed your panel. So other panels connected in series with that shaded panel also gets reduced. Its efficiency from 90% to 40%. All the connected in series get affected due to shading of one panel. Okay, so reduced to from 90% to 40%. So we have to avoid this one. How to avoid this one? Another one. Each string must have equal number of solar panels. That is another drawback of string inverters. How to be installed in same angle, same number of panels, same angle, and have to be same type. We cannot include other solar panels. For example, you are using monocrystalline. We cannot connect polycrystalline. So that is not permitted in case of string inverters. So number of solar panels should be same, connected in series, same angle should be installed, same type of solar panels should be connected. So these are drawbacks of string inverters. And third drawback is, in case of emergency, the utility grid can be shut down, but not the solar panel. Since you are getting the sunlight, as long as your sunlight is there, still it produces the electricity, solar panel. But due to emergency condition, the utility grid is shut down. Then string inverters. In this condition, cables from the roof, solar panel to inverter will still be under high tension. So it will affect your performance of your solar panel, solar plant. Then how to rectify this one? What is the rectification? How to solve this problem? Engineers, we have to think. So the solution is micro inverters and power optimizers. So with the help of micro inverters and power optimizers, all the three drawbacks can be rectified easily. But small disadvantage, it is expensive compared with string inverters, micro inverters and power optimizers. Since the micro inverters connected in back side of all solar panels, so it increases its costs. And power optimizer DC to DC converter actually. So solar panel output is DC, power optimizer output also DC. So there may be a centralized inverter is required for power optimizers. But micro inverters, no need of extra inverters. The micro inverters itself converts the DC to AC. So DC output from solar panel is converted to AC and can be exported to your power grid as well as to your electrical appliances. So that is the advantage of micro inverters and power optimizers. And due to shading, these two will not get affected, since it monitor each and every panel separately. So shading of one panel will not affect the other panels. So that is the important advantage. And moreover, for small area, this two is very advantage compared to string inverters, since we can installed in different angles. But in case of string inverters, it should be same angle. But here, in case of micro inverter and power optimizers, we can change the angle of your solar panels. And other type of solar panels also we can connect. But in case of string inverters, all the solar panels must be of same type. So those three disadvantages can be rectified with the help of micro inverters and power optimizers. So micro inverters install under every solar panel and converts DC to AC. Micro inverter connected to grid independent from other micro inverters, independent. When one solar panel gets affected, it will not affect the performance of other panels. The right voltage is found through a technique called maximum power point tracking. So micro inverters using this technique for monitoring. So maximum power point tracking. When the power fails, the micro inverter slows down and stop feeding the power into cables. Micro inverters expensive than string inverters. That is only drawback. And DC power optimizers splits traditional inverters into two products. One is power optimizer, DC to DC, and simplified inverters. So that DC from power optimizer is converted to AC with the help of simplified inverters. Optimizers install under each panel, like your micro inverter, and turning them into intelligent modules. So this acts like a intelligent modules. Due to that only, it will not affect other panels. So due to the shading only, that shader only affected. So that efficiency only reduced to 40%, but other panels still we are getting 90%, since it is not connected, separately monitored with the help of micro inverters or power optimizers. So that is the important advantage of this one. So by using panel level tracking and real time adjustments of current and voltage, the optimizers maximize the power output to the optimal working point of each panel. Due to this shading, the underperformed panels don't affect the output of other panels. During power shutdown in the grid, power optimizers reduce the power output of each panel to a low and safe voltage. So during the power shutdown time, the role of power optimizers reduce the power output to low and safe voltage. So low and safe voltage means it will not get affected. And micro inverters and power optimizers are module level power electronics. So comparison between string inverters and micro inverters. String inverters, entire system affected by one module, but here controlled independently. Susceptible to soiling, shading and module defects. But micro inverters resilient to environmental factors, not affected by the environmental factors. Leaf shading reduces its percentage to half in string inverters, but micro inverters increase by 20% compared to string inverters, since other panels not affected by the shading. But in case of string inverters, other panels connected in series gets affected and its efficiency reduced to 40%. This is actual 90% is reduced to 40% due to the shading of one wire. Then other research topics, solar power roads. So solar panels contain LED lights to create lines and signage without paint. They contain heating elements to prevent snow and ice accumulation. The panels have microprocessors which make them intelligent. So nowadays they are using the solar power roads. In future also all the roads can be replaced with the help of solar power roads. This is research topic. Still research is going on related with this. Then effect of color of light on solar cells. So that is another research area. So with the help of light intensity sensor, it is sensing the light. So a lot of research going here. How to avoid overheating of solar panels? So see, 0 degrees Celsius maximum voltage, and if temperature increases 75%, then the voltage gets reduced. So how to avoid overheating of solar panel? That is also one research topic. Then solar cells based on perovskite cells, a broad category of compounds characterized by a certain arrangement of their molecular structure that could produce dramatic improvements in solar installations. So this is MIT news. And another one is photovoltaic power sensors for the Internet of Things. So that is another research topic. Still it is going on. Then trends in solar energy. Now 2020, enough installed solar energy capacity in US to power 13.5 million homes. 2020. This amount is expected to double in next 5 years. So next 5 years is going to double in US. And demand for solar with battery storage increases. So the cost of solar batteries decreasing. Meanwhile, the prevalence of grid outages has climbed. There was a 30% increase in grid outage between 2009 and 2019, with a total of 37 million people affected in 2019. So the importance of battery increases, and electric vehicles boost electricity demand. Global electric vehicle sales are expected to reach 11 million units in 2020 and then surge to 97 million vehicles in 2025. So this is very notable point. And these vehicles require electricity to power them. Then solar battery prices are falling. The cost of lithium-ion battery storage 35% from the first half of 2018 to December 2019. Downward price trend is good news for renewable energy in 2020, and it's likely to continue. So solar battery prices are going down nowadays. So we can go for, actually the solar battery only expensive, but nowadays it is reducing. So we can go for solar battery, solar panels. And researchers have set a world record for the conversion of solar energy to electricity via the use of tiny nanoparticles called quantum dots. So the technology has a huge range of potential applications, including the possibility of as flexible, transparent skin to power cars, planes, homes, and wearable technology. So this is latest news, 2020 news. The University of Queensland team have developed quantum dot solar cells that can be made into thin, flexible films and used to generate electricity even in low light conditions. So this is recent news. It is developed by University of Queensland. So quantum dot solar cells. In future, definitely go for more applications. You can concentrate on this. Definitely you'll get very good. So with this, I can conclude today's topic. Once again, I thank the organizing committee and Satya Bhama University and Masa University for giving me this opportunity to deliver. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Dear participants, if you have any queries, you can discuss with Mr. Kasi Rajan, sir. Or even you can type in the chat box. Mr. Shrivesh. Mr. Shrivesh Nigam, do you have any doubt? Your raised hands and okay. Okay, that's the end of session. Thank you, sir. Now I call upon Dr. S. Karthikeyan, FIE, Fellowship Institute of Engineers, Head IEI Coordinator, Satyabhama IEI Student Branch, to deliver the vote of thanks.
On behalf of the management of Satyabhama Institute of Science and Technology, I take an immense pleasure in thanking Kasi Rajan sir. He has taken his valuable time and spent with us so that we can able to have a very good knowledge in the field of solar panels as well as how to design solar panels and research areas also. Some of the research areas, those who are interested, you can also proceed up and you can have a information, further information with Kasi Rajan sir. So I thank all the participants also. And last but not least, my friend Anthony Samrat, he has introduced Kasi Rajan sir. So I thank Anthony Samrat also. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Very good presentation. We had a very good informative session. So
thank you.
We are very thankful to you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Karthikeyan sir. Thank you, Kasi Rajan sir. Dear participants, thank you all once again. And your certificates, the link for downloading your certificates will be shared in the WhatsApp group as well as it will be shared in the through email in the registered email ID. Okay. And also the recorded session will be uploaded in the YouTube link Satyabhama IEI. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you all. Thank you all. Thank you.